Good afternoon, ma'am. So, in the previous classes, we have completed with sole proprietorship characteristics and advantages. So, today we are going to see with the disadvantages. Okay. So, in the disadvantages or demerits or limitations is same. Okay. If suppose in the examination is asked limitation of sole proprietorship, same points. Or as demerits of the sole proprietorship, same points. Or as disadvantages of sole proprietorship, same points. Okay. All of them comes under the same one question only. Okay. So here, first point you see, ma, limited resources. So why for sole proprietorship there is a limited resources means, see, ma, the resources of a sole proprietor are limited. He makes investments from his family sources only. There is a limit to which a single person can invest. He tries to raise finances from financial institutions also. These institutions want securities for these loans. The sole trader cannot offer much security, so he does not get much help from financial institutions. So here what happens means, why it is a limited resource? Because means a sole proprietor actually is a single person. He starts business with his own, he starts a business with his own sources only. Okay, own financial sources he will start, or else he will take from his family members, or else from relatives he will take and he will start the business. So here what happens means, even the financial institutions, they can't give him a loan. Why? Because compulsory he has to give some securities. After keeping some securities only, he will be getting a loan even from the financial institutions. So that's why the person who is starting a sole trade concern, he will be having a limited resources as compared to the joint stock companies, partnership companies. Okay. Second one, limited managerial ability. So why it is called as limited managerial ability? Because one person may not be expert in each and every function of the business. Okay, here what happens means, in case of sole proprietorship, only a single owner will be there. So here what happens means, he may not be expert in all the fields. So by that what happens means, his ability may be less over here. So if suppose he will be having more ability in production, in case of production, and he don't know how to market, regarding that goods. So then what happens, the goods which we are produced, okay, he can't sell those goods in the market. So here what happens is, that is a main drawback in case of sole proprietorship. So the person who is starting a sole proprietorship means, he should have a experience in all, in the production, marketing, advertising, and in maintaining accounts and everything. Then only he can run his organization in good manner, and finally he can achieve his target or goal. So here what happens is, as a single person, all the persons may not be that full-fledged in all the activities. That is a one of the disadvantage in case of sole proprietorship. Okay. Next, coming to the unlimited liability. So why it is unlimited liability? Because here in case of sole proprietorship, even his personal property is also liable. Okay. Why his personal property is liable? Because if suppose he is getting any losses in the organization, so in that case even his personal property will be liable, and total. So that's why it is a unlimited liability. But in case of joint stock companies, there we don't have any unlimited liability. But in case of sole proprietorship, compulsory even his private assets are also liable. Okay, if suppose business is going under losses, even his personal property is also liable over there. Next, uncertain continuity. So why it is called as uncertain continuity? Because if sole proprietor has died, nothing but the owner has died, so he has to discontinue the business. If suppose his legal heirs are continuing the business, they can continue. But as per the rules, sole proprietorship closes when the owner dies. Okay, next one. Limited scope for employees. Why there is a limited scope for employees means, see, ma, a sole trader cannot attract trained and qualified persons for years of limited career opportunities. Moreover, the continuity of sole trade business being uncertain, the employees also remain under psychological pressure. So here what happens means, why there is a limited scope of employees for that, what is the reason is it is a small scale business organization. So even the expert persons or as a well qualified person, they can't show that much of interest in joining a sole trade business, in joining a sole trade business. So that is the main thing here. So as per the, even the sole proprietor, he can't afford more wages or salaries, more salaries to the effective persons or efficient persons or well qualified as, so that is a one of the reason there is a limited scope for employees. Next, no large scale economies means a small scale concern cannot economize in purchase, production and marketing. Large scale enterprise will be able to have favorable terms of purchasing and selling the goods. In a sole trade concern, overhead expenses are also more, so this type of concern cannot enjoy the benefits of large scale economies. So why there is no large scale economies means here mainly it is a sole trade business. So here what happens means he can't purchase lump sum of raw material, and with that he can't even produce more goods. So that is one of the drawback here in case of sole proprietorship. So by that what happens, he can't compete with the large scale organizations also. So to reduce the expenses, first of all, what we have to do, he has to purchase the raw material in a bulk, and he has to produce the goods in that way, and even he has to sell the goods in that way. Then what happens means his expenses will be less. Next, more risk is involved. Why more risk is involved? Because all the decisions and everything is depend upon the single person only. If suppose he has taken any wrong decision, so by that what happens, total the firm will be nothing but the organization will be under the risk over here. Next, possibility of wrong decisions. Why there is a possibility of wrong decisions? Because here what happens, the decisions are taken by himself only. He can't consult anyone else. So if suppose he want to consult any good financial advisor also, he has to pay over their consultation fees for him. So what happens, in certain cases he may take the wrong decisions. So by that what happens, the firm will be under a pressure over there. Next, limited span of supervision. So why there is a limited span of supervision means, a sole proprietorship has to supervise various activities in the business himself. It becomes difficult for one person to supervise the work for every employee. So here why there is a limited span of supervision means, as sole proprietorship's total organization should be handled by only one person. So for the one person, it is difficult to organize all the activities, and it is difficult to control the employees also. Nothing but he can't supervise all the employees. So what happens here, if there is not a correct supervision, there is not a correct supervision in the organization, then what happens, the employees take it as an advantage, and there may be some misuses in the organization. So that's what here, in case of, this is also one of the drawback here. Nothing but one person can't supervise total organization. Next, weak bargaining position. Weak bargaining position means, a sole proprietor has a weak bargaining position both as a buyer and also seller. Since his purchasing power is limited, he has to buy whatever is available in the market, because large buyers can get better discounts and lower prices. So actually, what is a weak bargaining position, Weak bargaining position is nothing but, if suppose you want to purchase a raw material, it is a small scale organization. At a time, he won't purchase in lump sum. So if suppose he is not purchasing in a lump sum, what happens? As per the market rate, the buyers, they will give the raw material. Yes or no? If suppose he is purchasing in a lump sum, he may get a better discount and lower prices. That is a one more point. If suppose he want to sell the, after what happens, he is purchasing in a lesser quantity of raw material. After purchasing that raw material, now he has to produce the raw material and he has to complete into finished goods. After that, what happens here? He has to sell those goods after producing the goods, those goods will become finished goods. Now those finished goods should be sold in the market. So by that what happens, even he is purchasing the raw material is also in lesser quantities, and even he is selling the finished goods in the market is also in lesser quantities. So by that what happens here, the bargaining position will be weak. See, the buyers may not offer higher prices for small quantity of purchases. The same thing happens in sole proprietorship, in a shopkeeper or conducting any other business. So here what happens means, this is one of the drawback. He nothing but he has to as per his financial position, he has to purchase a raw material. If he is purchasing the raw material in lower quantity, what happens means he won't get any discounts from that buyer. And what happens after this, if he want to sell the goods in smaller quantity also, the seller he won't give more price, he will give only less price over there. Okay, next one. 11th one, higher employee turnover. Higher employee turnover means Sima. The turnover in small scale concerns is generally higher because the employees are paid lower remuneration and have high limited chances of for growth. The employees are not involved in important decisions making, may not be consulted from other business aspect. The owner takes. So higher employee turnover means regularly there will be a changes in the employees. Nothing but regularly employers will be changing over their position over there. Okay, why? Because it is a small scale concern, remunerations will also be low. If suppose an employee is getting a good chance in another company, means he will go to that companies. So that are the one of the reasons. Regularly there will be a changes in the employees. Okay, so that is the meaning of higher employee turnover. Okay. So these are the 11 disadvantages in case of sole proprietorship. So sole proprietorship, what are the topics are there in the syllabus? I have covered over now. So sole proprietorship, set advantages, characteristics and disadvantages. So sole proprietorship topic is over. Okay, tomorrow let us start with the partnership.